Hello YouTube makeup lovers, welcome back to my channel. If you're new to Be Lounge Makeup, I really hope that you guys stick around and subscribe for more videos. So I'm here today with a drugstore haul. I got a ton of goodies at Ulta. It has been such a long time since I actually buy drugstore items. And I mean, I've gotten drugstore items here and there, but I haven't done a drugstore haul in a really, really long time. But there were just so many items that I have heard so many great things about, and I really wanted to try it. There are also some makeup brands that they carry at the drugstore that I have never used. So Ulta.com was like the best for that because they have so many of those like drugstore brands, and then they also have those drugstore type brands that you can't find just like at CVS or Walgreens or something like that. So I was really excited just to try a couple of different products. They had a bunch of sales. They had like buy two and get one free. They had like buy one, get the second one 50% off. So that's why I kind of took advantage and got a lot of goodies. So let's get started with my drugstore haul. So the first two items I got, I actually got together because I was gonna use them together. And these are two items that I saw in a Makeup by Tiffany D video when she showed us her sunless tanning routine, and she recommended this Neutrogena. This is the Hydro Boost body gel cream. It has hyaluronic acid. I really wanted to get this one because it was a gel. I'm not the best at applying body creams. I tend to prefer like body oils that kind of just like you rub them and they disappear really fast. I feel like creams can get kind of sticky and they kind of annoy me if applied like all over the body. Like, I'm not really into like lathering thick creams all over my body. So this one, I really wanted to test it out because it's a gel cream, and anything that's more like a gel, less of a cream type of thing, usually is more comfortable for people like me who get kind of like icky with cream. So definitely wanted to test it out. This one I actually got at the drugstore. They were sold out of it at Ulta, so I actually picked this one up today at the drugstore. But I also got the Jergens Natural Glow Instant Sun in the Deep Bronze. This is a sunless tanning mousse, and this is supposed to be super easy to apply. It's pretty much something that you don't have to... The reason I got it was because you can kind of just apply it and go out the door pretty quickly. It's not something that you have to wait like hours and hours and hours for it to like, you know, for the color to like actually appear. So I just kind of like that quick type of thing. It's supposed to dry up in 60 seconds. So I kind of like, it's not supposed to be so fussy. So these are the two items that I got for the body. These are pretty much the only two items that I got for the body. So I did want to share them with you guys today. The rest is all makeup. So the very first makeup item that I wanted to try is this L'Oreal Paris Limited Mascara. This says it's a 24-hour lash lifting mascara. I got it in the blackest black. It's supposed to have unlimited length and lift. And I have never actually seen this one. This is what the packaging looks like. So it's like a funky package. Feels like really light. It almost feels like if it's empty. And this is how it opens. This is what the applicator looks like. So what is this here? So yeah, so I've never seen, oh, this like moves. Oh, this like moves around. See? So yeah, excited to test this mascara out. I got three items from Makeup Revolution. Makeup Revolution is a brand that I see all the time at CVS, at the drugstore, but I've never tested out any items. And I think they had like a buy two, get the third one free. So I did get three items from the brand. I tried to get the things, these had really good ratings on the website. So the very first thing I got is the Makeup Revolution Intensely Pigmented Foil Shadow Palette. So there you see all these colors. This is definitely not a palette that you could do like a full look with because it has no mattes, but I was really, really interested in seeing how these foiled shadow. Oh wow, that purple one had a great color pigmentation. Look at that. The second Makeup Revolution palette that I got is this highlighter palette. It says, actually, did I get two? No, that's like a blush. I was like, did I get two highlighter palettes? Well, I got a blush palette, but it looks like a highlighter palette. But anyways, the first one is the highlighter palette by Sophie. Is it Soph? I don't know, this is a collaboration with someone. So this is the Makeup Revolution highlighter palette. Try adding a little bit. That looks pretty nice. It made a difference. I'm just kind of using, Then I got this Vintage Lace Blush. This says Intense Dual Pigment Blusher. And it has these four shades. These seem very, very shimmery type of blushes. Let's see. Let me test them. I'm kind of in the mood to test these out. Let me try some of these and see if they're like extremely... Oh, yes. These have a lot of glitter. This is more like a highlight or like a topper. I don't know, but that's a lot of glitter. I don't know if you can tell in the camera, but in the mirror, whew, I see like the chunks of glitter. I wonder if maybe it's just that top layer that's chunky glitter. Oh, it seems like it's like, oh yeah, it seems like if the glitter just came off. I hope it's that way because I don't think I would want, yes, I feel like it's like the first layer. Let's try to take this one off.
Yeah.
So I feel like the glitter kind of comes off. It's just like a little glittery top. But then once you like take it off, I'm taking all that off because I do not want chunky glitter. See, it made a difference. It made a huge difference. I just added all that glitter all over my face. I mean, there's still shimmery colors. Yeah, I feel like that top layer of like glitter just came off. And now they look a lot more vibrant than they did before. So definitely want to play around with these. And I hope that it's not so shimmery, but it might be like a nice little topper. Now it looks a little bit iridescent. My cheeks look a little bit crazy. So this is the third palette from Makeup Revolution that I got. Next, I got this palette from L'Oreal. This is called the Chromatic Bronze Highlight and Contour Palette. It's actually broken. The bronzer broke, so I'm gonna open it for you guys, but I'm gonna throw this bronze shade out because it was like completely broken. I actually called and, you know, and mentioned, and they're gonna send me a new one. But these highlights, I feel like they're like so bright. I feel like this is a highlight that I could like totally put on my lid just because they're nice neutral shadows. But yeah, I'm excited to see what the bronzer looks like. But the three highlights, I really want to test out on my eyelid. And I feel like I would just do it with my finger and pop it on the eyelid. And that it would be really beautiful, especially this shade right here. Like, it just looks really, really nice. Next, I got the L'Oreal. This is the Infallible 24-Hour Fresh Wear Foundation. I got it in shade 425. I know that online it has a name. Here it doesn't say what the name would be, but I have heard so much about this foundation. L'Oreal usually always comes through for me in the foundation. My go-to drugstore foundation is the L'Oreal Infallible Pro Glow. I think this is like this foundation belongs like in Sephora. It belongs everywhere. It is just like a good quality foundation, not just good quality for the drugstore, good quality compared to any foundation. This to me is the best. I like foundations that are a little bit more, since I have drier skin, I like a little bit more glowy, dewy, more natural, more healthy. I feel like this one is not gonna be that way. It might be a little bit more full coverage, but not, it's not gonna be matte. But I have heard really great things about this foundation, so I really just had to try it. So I got this foundation to test it out. Let me know, of course, in the video, what you guys want me to do with all this makeup. I was thinking of also doing like just like a full face, trying out some of these drugstore products. Or if you want me to do like a full day wear, first impression type of thing with that one. I don't know. Let me know what you would like me to do. I also got the Maybelline. This is the Intense Age Rewind. These, I used to love these back in the day. They even changed the packaging a little bit. Like the label looks a little bit different. I got two shades. I got the light and I got the neutralizer shade. And this was like one of my go-to concealers back then. And I wanted to buy them again. It's been so long since I've tested them out. And I don't know, I just wanted to see if I still liked them like I used to love them. From Maybelline, I also got the Fit Me Loose Finishing Powder. I got the shade Fair Light. And this, I've heard, is excellent for setting your under eye area, for kind of like baking under here. I have never found a drugstore product that I felt did a good job with that as a under eye, you know, setting your concealer. So this one I've heard raves about. I heard it's a very good product, so I was very excited to test it out. From L'Oreal, I also got this small size of the Shake and Glow. This is a dew mist for the face. So I was excited to test this one out. I've also heard pretty good things about this one. Maybe I'll just try it out right now and see. Oh, it's like a very light, it's like a very light mist. I always do this with your mouth closed. I always like, it's supposed to be very, very good. Also heard really good reviews about it. I also got this cute little sponge from Essence. I thought it was just cute online. I haven't tried anything from this brand. It has kind of like the flat side, the point, and then, you know, the rounded sponge. So I kind of wanted to test it out. From the drugstore, I know that the Echo Tool sponge is really good. It's this one right here. This one I've used a lot. It does break up a little bit quicker than, you know, a beauty blender would. Like, I find that those don't last as long. But I mean, I think you can get the sponge for like under $5. So it's a really good sponge, and I wanted to test out a new one from Essence Beauty. I got some concealers from Catrice. These concealers, I know that they have been raved about on YouTube. I know Tati really likes this. When I watch her videos, she always recommends the Catrice ones. I have never tried it, which is kind of like why I like Ulta, because it has, like, you know, this type of brand like Catrice, where it's not a brand that I really see at like CVS or Walgreens, or at least I haven't seen them at my CVS and Walgreens. So I really wanted to test this one out. I got the shade 007 Natural Rose, and I got Fair Ivory, which they both seem very light. But yeah, so I got the Catrice concealers, and I also got the Catrice camouflage cream. This is like a peach corrector. This is what that looks like. So it's like a light peachy shade. So I figured for the under eye area, I wanted to test out this brand and see what it's all about. So excited for trying these. From L'Oreal, I also got the Telescopic Carbon Black Mascara. This is a mascara that I have tried before and I love it. So I just took advantage because I think they had like, I don't know, I needed an extra L'Oreal product to get an additional discount. So I just got something that I knew that I would love, and that mascara I always love. From Revlon, I got four of the ColorStay Cream Eyeshadows. These I was really excited about because I wanted to try other cream eyeshadows from the drugstore. I used to love the Maybelline Color Tattoos, but those dry up really fast. They don't like last all that much. My favorite one was Brad to the Bronze. It's still like such a beautiful color. So the first color here is called Praline, and it looks like this. And then I got this one in Honey, which is like a more goldeny, beigey type of color. Here, I have them swatched here, and those are those two. They're not showing up all that much like the other two are. The one that is called Caramel seems really nice. It's this one right here. That one is showing up really, really good. That one's that one right here. And the last color that I got is this pink one, which is the Cherry Blossom. This is actually what I have on my eyes right now. It is what I used as a base right before I used the Huda Beauty, the nude palette, which I thought this palette was so beautiful. I just filmed a video on this where I do, I'll go ahead and link it down below, because that video will probably be up before you guys see this video. And I pretty much do like a full face of trying on new makeup, where it's a mix of high-end makeup and drugstore makeup. So one of the high-end products was this palette that I was really excited to test out. For the foundation that I did today when I filmed the video, I tested out the Maybelline Dream Urban Cover foundation, and I tested out a bunch of other new products, both drugstore and high-end, even the L'Oreal, the Infallible concealer, the full wear one. I'm actually worried about this lighting. I'm not like loving the lighting. This is the second video that I film in here. I think the next video I film, I'm gonna go back outside to the living room until I figure out. I feel like it already got late. I started filming earlier. It was daytime and the window was going well, but now it's just like so dark in the back. I think I need to put some lights back there. I don't know. I'm really lighted up in here, but I'm not lighted up back there. I'm so sorry if the lighting sucks. Next two items I got were these Maybelline lipsticks. These are the Maybelline Shine. What are the names of these? One in the shade Undressed Pink and Baddest Beige. These are those very shiny lipsticks. This is what the packaging looks like. And this one is the Baddest Beige. So that is what Baddest Beige looks like. And then the other one is the Undressed Pink. They look like really pretty shades. So these are supposed to be very, very shiny lipsticks, but it's a lipstick, not a gloss. From L'Oreal, I also got this Chromatic Bronze Lip Topper. This is in the shade Cosmo Girl, and it's supposed to be like a nice little lip topper to like brighten up the lips, add a little bit of something something. And I've never really tried a lip topper from the drugstore. I actually really have not really tried many lip toppers at all. The first one I ever got, I think, was like the Jouer one. This is, I don't know if you can see that color. Let me add a little bit to like the center. Let me just add it to the whole thing. Okay, so that's that. And the last item I got is this bronzer from BH Cosmetics. This is the Brilliant Bronzer. And I got the shade Golden Gal. This is what it looks like. And I've also heard that this bronzer is a very good bronzer. So I definitely want to test it out. I think I pretty much have a full face of makeup that I can try on. So that is pretty much it. I really hope that you guys enjoyed this drugstore haul. Please let me know what you guys want me to do with all this makeup. I was thinking of maybe doing a full face of drugstore makeup where I give you guys my first impressions. Or do you guys want me to do a full-on review of this foundation and like a wear test? I don't know, maybe a combination of the two. Let me know what you guys would like me to do with all this drugstore makeup, because I definitely want to do another video where I test these things out. I have so much fun testing out my makeup with you guys. I just really hope that you guys enjoy it too, and that's what you want. So leave me in your comments below what you would like me to do with the drugstore makeup. I will also list everything in the description box down below, just in case during the video when I filmed it I didn't say the name correctly or I left out a part of it. I always like to write everything in the description box down below. As always, I just want to say thank you so much for watching my videos. I hope that you guys subscribe to my channel before you go, and don't forget to ring the notification bell so that you guys get notified when I upload a new video, and I will talk to you guys very, very soon. Bye.